Rendering with color pencil is no different from what we have learned previously. It just the difference here is you basically is the color. Instead of pencil as black and white, you use color. You still use the normal pencil for creating the different shading. But as you create some basic color for the material that you have chosen. You can, if your pencil is soft, you could do it straight, and if it's not soft and a bit hard, then you could use this Q-tips that you use for cleaning your ear to blend it a little bit. And also depends on the type of paper that you're using. If the paper is smooth, then you may get luck with the pencil, but if not, then again you can use the blender. You could also use your finger if you like. It's smooth for you. If the material is rough, then the basic color before I start putting the sheet. You notice here I was a bit generous with the pressure I put on the pencil, so you can see there's a difference between the amount of color that I put. Gray implies shading, remember? You know, as you can see it, even when I'm coloring right now, you see shading right there. See, the shading here is not black, it's gray. In terms of color pencil, that means I use the technique that is called layering. So I put a layer of black or gray on top of the mauve color that I'm using right now, and I would allow it to show through. I repeat, it has to show through. So when it shows through, then it would really show a true indication of the gray. So I'm going to use the black, for example, right now. I'm going to leave this here, and then I'm taking the black. And then if I go like this, see, I'm not pressing too hard. I'm not engraving. I'm just tickling it, or I'm trying to put a soft layer that would show through. Can you see that on the corner right there? Yeah? See it? So I'm just trying to put a little bit of this here to imply that there is a shaded area, because it's totally against the, you know, the light source. You understand what I'm doing? Yeah, there you go. So this area is totally filled right there. But again, without pressing, I'm not engraving, I'm not doing this. I am just tickling it. I'm letting the other color go through. So it's like you're putting a layer, it's like you're wearing a sunglasses. The sunglasses is dark, so it makes things that you see through darker, but it doesn't make it totally black. Here, meaning I pressed a little bit, or I put to me. It doesn't hurt at all to go back and again tickle it with the original color, because we don't want to put too much gray on white so it looks like a gray armrest. We still have to maintain the color that we chose, and this is the color that we chose. Okay? A layer of that color is going on top, as opposed to this, for example, because I know that this is, no matter what, it's against the light, so it's going to be later darker. Here, it's light, and then it gets a bit darker, and then it gets a bit darker. All right? Then I continue to fill the rest of the sofa. It doesn't hurt every once in a while to rotate the pencil, make it turn. That would ensure that you have always a pointed pen that would allow you to, or a pointed edge that would allow you always to maintain a very consistent type of hatching. Shift to black, emphasis for darkness. The color of the pillow, I decided to leave it white to contrast in a very soft way with the rest of the sofa. So I'm going to divide this according to the light source into three different zones again. Darker here, and then I fade it out to go to the top. So darker, and it goes up. I said white, so the gray of the darker tone of the white is gray. This is called blending. You make everything blend together, no sharp edges and stuff like that. It's just final touches. And again, what you need to do at the end is to sign it, and it's finished. Thank you for your attention, and I hope it helped. Take care and go back to work. Bye-bye.